Okay, guys, so here's what I got for you. This is what I'm going to call a double pulse Rodin coil motor, or right now it's a Starship coil motor, but you can do the same thing with the Rodin coil. But basically, here's what I've done. It's very, very simple. I've taken a PC fan. Here's what's left of it. Okay, a standard PC fan. This was a pretty big fan. I think it was like 3.3 amps, which is a good amount. Here's the coil out of it. It is a biflare wound coil. And the circuitry for it is right here. It's got a hall sensor. It's got a driver that actually, this controls everything. It controls two transistors, and those control these other, I don't know if these are MOSFETs or transistors. They don't really have any numbers on them. So that's fine. But basically, what I'm done is taking a PC fan, standard PC fan, taking the circuitry out of it, unmodified, and hooked it directly up to a Starship or a Rodin coil, or an April Wine coil, I'm sure. I haven't got that far yet. So, as far as I know, I am the first one to try this particular type of circuit with a Rodin, Starship, any of those type of coils. If someone else has done it and you have a video up, let me know. But as far as I know, I'm the first person to try it or to do it. So this is an unmodified circuit directly out of a fan. Now, there are plenty of different type of fans, different things going on with each one. I believe most of them will work the same. Basically, you just take the coil off of it, and there's three pins on there. You take the first one, and it's either you got to find the common, basically, and tie those two together. So what I have here is both my commons on my Starship coil here are tied together, and they are going to one part of the circuit, which is this one here. And then the other one has the other part is two separate coils, basically for the north and the south poles, and those two are here. Each one of those goes to one of the coils on the other side, so they come back to common. That's how you complete your circuit. Again, I believe I'm the first person to try this, so I'm gonna just call this a you know, Rodin fan motor modification. I don't know what to call it. Make me a name up. So here we go. I'm gonna set you up here and show you what I got. Now, what I like about this circuit is that these fan motors basically have a sensor in them, or the driver chip here tells it whether or not it's spinning or stalled. If it stalls, it quits, and then it tries to cycle again. So basically what I'm telling you is I do not need to start the magnet. It runs by itself. All I have to do is get it close to the sensor in the coil, and it takes off, which is awesome. Here we go. Okay, guys, so I'm just going to set this in here. And set this right here and hold it. Now, all I'm going to do is connect power and watch this. It'll take off all by itself. Ready now. So, that took off all by itself. I didn't do anything. I can pull it away. It's going to quit running. I can put it back. Well, sometimes you got to turn it. There you go. Now, it took off all by itself. I didn't do anything. Then, once you get it going, you can get it positioned where you want it, as far as your highest RPM or lowest amperage, whatever you want to try. I figured about right in this area gets going pretty good. I'll just let it build up some speed here, see how fast we can get it going. Still building speed. Again, I'm using plastic because I've heard a lot of people, their magnets wearing out. This thing's probably going to take off. Basically, this thing will run by itself. I can just let it sit. So there you go. Still picking up speed. So this is officially the first time I've ever seen somebody take a PC fan and directly connected to a Rodin coil, and it runs just like is. No modifications to the circuit at all. Anybody can do that. PC fans are everywhere. As you can tell, I've only taken a few apart. I can't tell you the RPM of that, but it is flying. So I'm going to disconnect the power here, and I'm going to put a smaller Neo sphere in there and see if we can't get it to spin up, because the smaller the magnet, I have found out that the faster it goes. That is very annoying. That thing's flying. Alright, I'll be back with a smaller magnet. There's no oil on the lid. Ta-da! Okay. Oh, by the way, the oil I'm using in this plastic is heavy-duty silicone. CRC. Works really well. I use it on my Rubik's Cubes, actually. I know. I'm a Rubik's Cube guy. Okay. I'll get a smaller Neo. Okay, guys. I got a... I believe this is a 3/8. I'm not sure. I forgot. 42-inch Neo sphere. I'm going to fire this thing up. I'm going to just hook it up and see if it takes off. I tried. Again, this circuit should take off by itself. There it goes. Man, this thing's flying. I can't tell you the RPM. I don't know. I can guarantee you, though, it's all... Okay, guys, so check it out. Now, what I have here is a 3/4-inch dynamically magnetized magnet on a rod. Again, this is self-starting. See if I can get it to go here. There it's going. Now, I do not have bearings, as I said. And I believe this shaft is bent. But it's got enough torque to run. There we go. Neo sphere. Listen to that puppy purr. I am pulling, as it's getting faster, pulling, well, that's different. That's not different, but it's changing. We'll call it 25 milliamp. It's going down. I don't know what the original fan sticker said on it. But, that puppy's flying! And again, this is an unmodified circuit. All I did was connect my Starship coil, or Rodin coil if you have one, and the thing runs. That's awesome. It, I'm down about 22 milliamp, going back up. So this particular chip actually controls the speed. It's got oscillator in it, which is supposed to control how fast it runs. I can't tell you if it's working, because that sucker's flying. Okay, guys, so for now, until I make a modified version of basically a fan motor, but I'll be using my own circuitry. And if you haven't seen my previous video, I used just a standard Hall effect sensor. And again, you can get those out of fan motors. Here's a little bitty one, and there's the Hall sensor. Now, what you have to watch out for is that some of the Hall sensors are a little different. They're actually driver chips. They're designed to run only Like this particular motor has basically no other components. I did strip a transistor off there, but two resistors, a transistor, and the Hall effect chip. Now the Hall effect sensor on this particular one, I actually got to look up the number, and basically it's a driver. The whole thing is, so it's kind of self-contained, but you can still use the signals. What I'd like to do is use the signals from this, drive bigger MOSFETs, and I can actually dump more power into my Rodin coil or Starship coil or whatever you use. Here we go. So again, all I have to do is hook it up and it self-starts. Ta-da! Now, as I was saying in my previous video, basically what I've seen so far is everybody uses a standard Hall effect sensor, and it's just, it's basically only one whole revolution it gets pulsed. That's it. Basically what this circuit's doing is it's pulsing both polarities at different times, therefore in turn oscillating back and forth rather than just one. Now I would think there'd be more torque and maybe more RPM, but definitely more torque. I'm going to open this. The reason I put the lid on it because some of the other magnets flew out of here. Have fun time finding them. But I'll go ahead and take this off, get this going, and see what kind of torque it's got. Now I believe the driver circuit is actually going to tell itself that it's slowing down and release some current so it doesn't overdrive itself. It's pretty interesting. My amp rating's going down slowly. That's got a decent, burning my fingers. Got a decent amount of torque. Okay, here's another smaller needle sphere. Thing's flying. That is fast, guys and girls and boys and women. All right. I forgot.